Hi, my name is AnnMarie Kolakowski. I'm a librarian with the Pasadena Public Library. I work out of the Central Library in the Youth Services Department, and I'm here to show you today how you can check out library books using your PUSD Chromebook through the Sora app. This is going to broaden your book selection so much because the Pasadena Public Library buys a lot of books on Overdrive, and we try to buy all the popular titles that kids are looking for, and we are so excited that these titles are going to be available to your students without your students even needing a library card. It just has a bit of a setup process, so I'm going to walk you through that, and then once you have all that setup done, you won't have to do it again. So this is how to check out library books with Sora. Okay, so first what you're going to do is you're going to open your Chromebook and go to Clever, and then you need to look under the PUSD approved applications, and down there in the right hand corner, at least that's how it appears on the screen I was looking on, you'll see the little astronaut character for Sora. So you're going to click on that. Okay, once you get to Sora, there will be a green button that you need to click for Find My School. And it'll show you a bunch of schools that are not your school. So you need to go down to My School is listed at the bottom. Now here's one of the first of many tricky things. You're not going to search for your individual schools. So if you go to Madison or McKinley or Jackson or something, you're not going to put in your school name. You're actually going to put in Pasadena Unified, because Pasadena Unified School District has their whole collection on Sora as Pasadena Unified School District. That's what you're going to sign into. And you're going to say, this is my school. Okay. So it's really more like you're signing into your school district, but the way that their website is worded, it looks like you're saying that that's your school. Okay, so they will ask you to confirm that you are signing into Pasadena Unified School District. Click Sign In. And at the bottom of your screen, you'll see a navigation bar that has four main sections: Home, Explore, Shelf, and Me. And the home is like a little bit of everything. Explore is where we want to go next. That's how we're going to search for titles to read. So the easiest way to add Pasadena Public Library to the collections that you can search from is to go up to the upper left where you see Pasadena Unified School District and a little drop down arrow. Click on that in order to get a green button that says Add a Library. Now what you're going to do is do a search for Pasadena Public Library. There are other Pasadena Public Libraries in North America, so you'll see one that comes up in Canada and one that comes up in Texas, but the one that is listed without any addresses for some reason is the one that you want to click on. It's the one that says just Pasadena Public Library, and it just says branches, because we have a lot of different branches, so I think maybe it was hard for them to just pick one address. You're going to click on This is My Library. Now, you will see our logo appear in the upper right with the picture of the Central Library with the three little palm trees, and that shows you are now viewing the books that the public library has made available in our Overdrive collection. We pay for these books and provide them to the public through Overdrive, and Sora is connected to Overdrive, so you're going to be able to get them through Sora now. through the public library, you get access to all these popular authors like Dev Pilkey and Jeff Kinney and Rick Riordan, and definitely all the main award-winning books. So we're really excited to be able to offer you that in a way that is super easy for you to access after you do these steps, of course. So when you're searching for a book, I put in a search for Wimpy Kid, and you're going to check the box for search all my libraries. That just broadens your search so you can see what PUSD has and what Pasadena Public Library has, and you can check out anything from any of those sources. Here you'll get results for both PUSD and Pasadena Public Library, and you, as you can see, Pasadena Public Library has a lot of different things for Wimpy Kid. These things all say place hold. That means that they're currently checked out by someone. So if it says place hold, what that will do is it will alert you when the item is available for you to check out so that you can be the next person to read it. In place of that, it will say borrow if the item is available for you right now. When you go to borrow a book or place a book, a hold on a book that you want, you'll be asked to sign into your library again. Here's another tricky thing. If you sign in, if you click sign in using Pasadena Public Library, they're going to ask you for your library card. And we have really made this available for you guys just through your PUSD credentials. You don't need a library card if you are a PUSD student. You don't need a library card to check out our eBooks. So I'm going to show you another workaround for that. Instead of signing in to Pasadena Public Library, remember to sign in using Pasadena Unified School District. So use that drop-down menu, find Pasadena Unified School District, click the green sign in button, and you'll be able to still check out public library books as a school district student. So I did another search because I wanted to see something that we could borrow today. So Big Nate is also really fun and popular. So here it's showing an example of a book that we can borrow right now. Big Nate, Silent But Deadly. So when you click on borrow, you have to sign in using PUSD. And then it opens up the book. There are tools at the top and at the bottom for things like changing the text size and skipping to certain chapters. You can also just click anywhere on the picture of the book to start reading in full screen mode. And when you want to turn the page, you just click on the right side of the page. Sora has a fun little thing where they give you achievements for doing things like checking out your first book. So that's fun. And you'll be able to see those things in your Me section on Sora. So let's say I really want an audiobook, actually. I'm not looking for an ebook. I want one that will read aloud to me. You can limit your search using the various different tags that they have at the top. So after you have put in Big Nate, it will say your search included 5 audiobooks, 40 humor books, 38 comic and graphic books, etc., etc. So you can click on it that way, or you can use the refine button in the upper right. That will also help you to refine your search options. This is useful for things like selecting what format you want your book to come in, because there are ebooks that you can just read on screen and there are audiobooks that you can listen to. When you borrow an audiobook, you have buttons for play pause, skip back 15 seconds or skip forward 15 seconds. If you need to skip a long way, you can just click those buttons over and over again. If there's a book that you want to remember for later, you can add it to your wish list. So the wish lists are nice for things like, oh, you know, I really want to read that book, but not until I'm done reading the one that comes right before it. You put it on your wish list. You can also tell Sora which books you have already done, and you're going to indicate that by either saying you liked it or you didn't like it. Thumbs up or thumbs down. To see all your current loans, click on Shelf at the bottom of your screen, and that will show it'll show your loans, your holds, your lists, and your history. So here we're looking at the lists. I circled these because it looks kind of weird. You see the words wish list way over at the left, but you see the actual books in my wish list way over at the right. So just wanted you to know. And it'll also show you everything that you have liked or disliked. The books that you currently have on loan will appear under loans, and you'll see when they're due. This one, it's kind of hard to see, but it says due in 30 days. Now, when the books come due, they just go away. They just disappear. You don't have to do anything. You don't have to remember that it's coming due. It's just letting you know when it comes due so that you can try to read it before it comes due. But it'll still be in your history, so you can always look back and check it out again if you need to, if you lost track of it. So in your history, it shows you all the books that you borrowed in the past. Basically, the default is set to just showing your whole entire history, but you can disable that or clear your history if you don't want to see those titles anymore. Or you can remove specific titles that you don't want to see anymore, or maybe you don't want anyone else to see. Okay, so if you click Me at the bottom, you'll see your current loans and any assignments that you have from your teachers. So teachers can actually assign books to you using the Sora app. I think it works similar to Epic, but I don't have the ability to test that out. So if you click the round button with the three straight lines in the upper right, you'll see options for changing your settings. Like you can add another library if there's another library that that has a collection with Overdrive. You can change your settings for things like what language you want everything to appear in. Keep in mind that it doesn't change the language of the books themselves. It just changes the wording on the website. Also, you can change things about your hold settings or your download settings or look for help. And finally, it gives you a nickname that just says your nickname, and you get to set your own nickname. So when you want to do that, you just click in the Me option on the bottom of your screen. And if you click on your nickname, it'll say enter your nickname, and now you can actually put your name. So now you're all set to borrow books from us. You're never going to have to do all that setup again because Clever is going to remember your settings for Sora. So I believe you shouldn't have to do that again. In the future, when you go to Sora, Pasadena Public Library will already be set to be one of your libraries. And at the very most, you may just be asked to sign in, and remember, sign in using PUSD. So I really hope that you enjoy all the fun and popular books that you can check out from both PUSD and Pasadena Public Library's collections in the Sora app. And if you have any issues or questions, please feel free to reach out to us. Anyone in the Youth Services Department can probably help you with this, especially Jennifer Driscoll, Jane Gov, or myself, AnnMarie Kolakowski. We can give you a hand with navigating, you know, where things are in Sora if you're having any troubles with that. So thank you so much, and I hope that you get to check out lots of fun things. And let us know how you like it and how the experience is for you. Take care.